Welcome back to Technique Tuesday. Today we're going to talk about the difference between closed dance position and promenade position. So we use promenade dance position in many different dances. So far, waltz, foxy, we use it, foxtrot, tango, a lot of the smooth dances, even some of the rhythm and Latin ones use promenade dance position. We're going to focus more on, like, we're going to use waltz right now as the example. But the difference between closed dance position, which is when we're facing or square parallel to one another, and promenade dance position is when we're opened up a little bit and then moving in a different direction. So if I look at first the alignment of one another, right? Yes, we're left aligned to each other in closed dance position and in promenade, but when we go to promenade, we're not left aligned anymore. She's actually a little bit behind me. Because we were left aligned before, when we both go and open up ourselves very slightly into promenade, you can see in relation to our new direction, she should feel and is behind me instead of right next to me in promenade. So that's the very first thing. The next thing is going to be, the only things we want to think about that actually turn or rotate into promenade are our eyes and our toes. So if I go and we both turn to promenade, my eyes turn to look in the direction that I want to go in, for hers more than mine, right, as the follower. And then our toes turn a little bit, and when our toes turn, it takes our hips and our shoulders a little bit to the left, and we're trying to keep them as close towards our partner as we can. So I don't want to think about opening my shoulders or my hips because I usually end up going too far and being too open in my new direction. So if I think my eyes turn and my toes only turn an eighth of a turn, so we're both pointed like this now, kind of on a diagonal. So that if we were to now walk across and promenade together, every time we took a step, let's say we go with our front foot first, we're going to try to keep our toes turned in a little bit on this diagonal so that we stay towards one another as we go to take all these steps. If my toes point straight forward, my hips, my shoulders, my body's probably going to want to point straight forward too. So if I can keep my toes turned, you can see my hips automatically react to the direction of my toes. Or if I point them straight forward, it's gonna be really hard to fight that and dance this properly if I point straight down the floor. So you could say nose and toes or eyes and toes turn towards promenade, and we're trying to stay towards each other as much as possible as we go walk in this new direction. The next thing here is if we go with our inside foot, my right and her left foot here, this is a walk in an advanced term called CBM, or contra body movement position, where we go and walk contra of where our body's facing. My body is technically facing here, not my eyes, but my chest is pointing this direction as hers is pointing this direction, but my foot is actually traveling towards you, the camera. So my foot is traveling in a different direction than my body's pointing, which is kind of like the introduction to contra body movement, or me walking and dancing across myself instead of directly in the direction that my body, is facing. So when we go take our step with the inside foot, we're walking forward across ourselves, and then if I were to close up, like in waltz, then we'd go back to closed dance position. So as we transition here and do like a basic twinkle, we start in closed dance position. My eyes and my toes both turn to face this direction as we stay close towards one another. As we go to take our first step here, inside foot across ourselves, you can see our toes are pointed in slightly, and then not until we go to close up to one another do we fully get parallel and point towards one another, and trying to stay as close as you can towards one another makes it much, much more seamless.
So to sum up, the major differences between closed hold and promenade is gonna be our feet and our nose or our eyes. So in closed hold, ideally we're going to be left aligned, like he said, and we're also going to be over our windows, for example, like in waltz, dances that are going to travel around a little bit more. You could keep it more casual and look at one another. That's another option if you're doing like a wedding dance. But if we're talking like a little more advanced, we're going to be just over our window looking off to the left. And then for our promenade, we're trying to keep everything else but our feet and our head the same. So we're twisting and turning followers to the right and then leaders to the left. So that way my eyes are now going over the hand and then my feet are gonna be not straight towards my partner, just an eighth to my right and his left. So that's the major differences between the two positions itself.
Thanks for joining us on Technique Tuesday, and we will see you next week.